Hey, take one.
CBS presents this program in color.
From Television City in Hollywood.
The Red Skelton Hour.
Ahoy, mate, it's a joy, mate, that you're gonna be coming along.
For a pleasure trip
on a treasure ship with a cargo of laughter and song.
Start grabbing for a cabin, we'll be tossing the anchors away.
Once we meet a few
of the happy crew
that is crossing this channel today, our guests are Johnny Mathis.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I feel good. You know what I did last week? Dean Martin and myself, we went downtown to play a benefit, see? And we go over this little bridge. He says, what river is that? I said, that's the Los Angeles River. He says, I think I'll go for a swim. Well, before I could tell him that there's no water in the thing, he came back up and he says, boy, what a nutty river that is. The bottom's on top. You know what's fun this time of the year? Everybody's getting ready for Halloween, you know. Halloween. You know, my idea of a real Halloween would be having play Trick or Treat at Peyton Place. I got a real Halloween shock last year. I opened up the door, and there was a fella standing there dressed like a witch. Had a big pointed hat, you know, and long, stringy fingernails, and a red, big red nose. And he says, Trick or Treat. I says, Trick or Treat. It was my psychiatrist. I'm only kidding. I don't go to psychiatrists. You know what I did about 10 years ago? I looked around at what all the sane people were doing, so I figured I'd rather be better off nutty. One thing I found out about me, I'm nuts, I admit it, see? I found out one thing, as long as I make money, they ain't gonna lock me up. I don't know if you're applauding the fact I'm nutty or they're not gonna lock me up. You don't like about what's good about Halloween? That's the only time of the year when the Beatle haircuts look right. I remember one Halloween, I went over to George's folks, her aunt came out, and she had these big buck teeth and big, long, hairy eyebrows and hairy hands. She says, did you get a costume for me? You know where Halloween is rather unusual is in Beverly Hills. Where else can you see a mink pumpkin? You know, Beverly Hills is unusual with the children there. All the kids, it's a fad, you know, mostly having braces on their teeth. Boy, you know that Pied Piper ever went to Beverly Hills? He wouldn't need a flute. All he'd need was a magnet. And you'd always tell the movie stars home at Halloween, if it's a tall pumpkin, that's John Wayne's house. If it's a short pumpkin, that's the Mickey Rooney's. Stewed pumpkin, Dean Martin. Hey, did you know that old Dean Martin is an expert on ghosts? He's always getting messages from departed spirits. You know, I love ghost stories, you know. As a matter of fact, I have a book that's out called There's a Red Skeleton in Your Closet. And I also got an album. Here, give me the album. I just will plug everything. I got a car I want to sell, too, you know. I got a new album that's out, too. How about that? Yeah. I got that in. Hey, but in this book that I got, there's one story in there about this fellow who meets this ghost in this old castle. And she appears, and he says, "Who are you?" She says, "I am the spirit of Lady Macbeth. I have been walking these halls for 600 years. He said, "600 years?" She says, "Yeah, I can't find the powder room." And you know, on Halloween, what's fun, too? They always run on television those old scary movies. I remember last year we was watching one, and they got the commercial mixed up with the plot. This big bat flew through the window, and it was Dracula. He said, "The only way to fly." Hey, I got one for you. Who's this? Who's this? That's Dracula after drinking tired blood. Hey, at one masquerade party I went to last year, I went in and Georgia was standing there. She had on this red costume with little horns and a big long tail and a pitchfork. She says, "How do I look?" And I made my first mistake. I said, "You look like the devil." And there was one fellow at this masquerade ball. He came in, he had about 1,000 yards of bandage all around him. See, I says, "Are you an Egyptian mummy?" He says, "No, California pedestrian." And in New York, Halloween will be different this year on account of the dry spell they're having there. This year, they're going to fill a tub with apples and bob for water. You know how I'm going this year at a masquerade ball? I'm going to go as a cagabeer. A cavalier. Well, I've always wanted to play one of those parts, you know, those swashbuckling guys. The only trouble with me, I buckle where I'm supposed to swash. But I'd like to do now, if I may, a little short pantomime of a fellow fighting a duel, one of those cavaliers fighting a duel.
Ladies and gentlemen, our guest star, Johnny Mathis, with the Tom Hansen Band.
On a morning like this, I could kiss everybody. I'm so full of love and goodwill. On a wonderful day like today, I defy any cloud to appear in the sky, and dare any raindrop to plop in my eye. On a wonderful day like today, on a wonderful morning like this, when the sun is as big as a yellow balloon, even the sparrows are singing in tune. On a wonderful morning like this, on a morning like this, I could kiss everybody. I'm so full of love and goodwill. Let me say, furthermore, I'd adore everybody. Come and dine, the pleasure's mine, and I will pay the bill. May I take this occasion to say that the whole human race should go down on its knees. Show that we're grateful for mornings like these, for the world's in a wonderful way, on a wonderful day like today.
Thank you. all you people, whatever is cramping your style. Come to me, cause I'm sure I can cure all you people. Don't be afraid, your fortune's made as long as you can smile. Life's a game that is easy to play. You'll be lucky in spite of the chances you take. Laugh at the sight of a mirror you break, or a cat that is crossing your way on a wonderful day.
Red Skelton as Deadeye and Johnny Mathis in Here Comes the Bribe.
Well, folks, Deadeye sure ain't gonna get himself elected to sheriff this year.
That's right, Mr. Mayor. He's got somebody running against him this time. Singing Johnny Appleworm.
Yeah. Well, here comes Sheriff Deadeye now.
Them darn spurs, I thank you for the applause. My folks thank you, and Horse Courtrod thanks you, too. Howdy. Sorry I was late, but I've been riding on the range all day.
Riding the range?
Riding the range.
Deadeye, how come you walk so funny?
Somebody forgot to turn the pilot light off.
Then are you sure are bow-legged?
I ain't so bow-legged.
Oh? Then how come you're standing on both sides of me?
I admit I have to press my pants over a barrel, but outside of that, I'm sorry I said it in the first place.
How are you going to campaign this year, Deadeye?
By handing out lollipops to babies and then kissing them.
I ain't no baby.
Then give me back my lollipop. Give me back my kiss, too. Oh, I'll get that later. Where can I get the hold of you later?
I don't know. I'm a little ticklish.
Yeah. Well, I'll remember, folks. The kisses for the girls and cigars for the men. You can vote twice, you'd be a chain smoker. Or a chain smoocher.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm a girl.
Have a cigar.
Wait. I swan.
Swan, you look more like a stuffed penguin. Well, boy, meat was cheap when she was born, I tell you.
What about the dance hall girls, Deadeye?
Well.
Will you give them a fair shake?
Well, you got a pretty fair shake there already, you know. Yes, sir. Boy, that'll wind the clock in your socks every time, I'll tell
you. Hey, yeah. Deadeye, you know something.
What is it, Dean? I know an awful lot, boy. I'll tell you, this ain't a Japanese sketch, but we're going to make it one right now. You've been gargling that sheep dip again. Would you mind breathing the other way? You're bleaching my mustache.
You know something, Deadeye? You're a nice guy.
Yeah?
And I'm going to vote for you if I can make it to the polls.
Fine.
Hey, look at the geese flying south for the winter. How about that? Breathe up, man. Breathe up.
Hey, you're better than a 16-gauge shotgun.
Man, that's the limit.
Did I? Mm-hmm. How about that roast pig?
Oh, forget him. He can't vote. He's dead.
Oh, no, no, no. I mean, when do we eat?
Right now. Line up for a taste of pork. I say, this ties in with my campaign slogan. You can trust me in a pig's eye. Now, everybody stick your tongues out. Bend over if you got your tongue. There you are. Licking a smell for everybody. Licking a smell.
Don't did I? What are we doing this for?
Politics is a lot of hogwash. I just wanted to show you how to wash a hog.
Well, we're hungry and we want to eat.
Well, we just will eat the pig. I don't think he's going to last another 4 years. Besides, his apple getting a little moldy there. Yeah. Now, everybody eat. Everybody.
Oh, wonderful.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Come here, gentlemen. Come here. This is the West. Where is your manners? Ladies are first. I don't know on what bus, but ladies are first. Now, we shall all be gentlemen and eat. Ladies first. Here we go.
Well, it looks like the Battle of the Bulge is back again.
You know that you ate everything but the oink?
Oink? Ladies and gentlemen, before I talk, I'd like to say something.
Oh, I hear that the Temperance League just took a vacation there.
Well, there's a man that knows when to stop to drink. When he hits the ground, that's it.
Here comes your opponent for sheriff, the singing balladeer, Johnny Appleworm.
Hey, how come he never talks, just sings?
He just sings because when he was a baby, he was vaccinated with a Victrola needle. He's the first kid that ever burped a course of tiptoe through the tulip. There he is.
All right, Johnny Appleworm, if you've got something to sing against me, go right ahead.
Okay, folks, let's give him a C.
I'd like to give him H myself.
Oh, the Hummer's in the group. You sound like a bunch of rejects from the King family.
Don't vote for old Deadeye, dear neighbors and chums. He'll steal all the inlays right out of your guns.
Now, wait a minute. I demand a lawyer or a lyric writer.
He filled up the stagecoach and robbed the Swiss bank. He'll take out the tiger right out of your tank.
Now, hold on there. Now, to show you how honest I am, I can't even afford a guitar.
See how it is, folks, when you believe?
You'll never convict me of being a louse. We'll find all the money by searching your house.
Yeah, come on.
Now wait a minute.
Don't look through my house, folks. I have to confess. My maid's on vacation and the place is a mess. Here is the mansion of Deadeye the Crook. It's packed to the rafters with stuff that he took.
Imagine! The most dishonest man in the entire territory is our sheriff.
Well, if we find anything around here that Deadeye has stolen, he'll never win the election, by Joseph. Ah!
Well, using my house for hanky-panky, huh, man? Well, I didn't think your hanky could panky anymore.
Did I? This happens to be my wife.
Insanity is no excuse.
Sheriff, we haven't uncovered any evidence of your dishonesty.
Well, of course not. You've been too busy smooching.
The stagecoach was held up last week by a man with a mustache.
Oh, really? Well, it couldn't have been me because I use a revolver.
Hell of a mustache with a...
Deadeye, the money's still missing. What you got in that safe?
I'll show you what I got in this safe. 36... 23? Didn't do much good to lock it, did it? 36?
23-36.
Wow.
What's that?
Like I told you, 36-23-36.
Maybe she's hiding the money.
In that dress, she can't even hide herself. You know, I was going to make her my deputy, but I couldn't find a place to pin the badge.
Did I?
Yeah.
Johnny Appleworm sang that we would find the stolen stagecoach money here.
Now, you can't believe that top 10 tin horn. Says them things about me. Believe me, I never stole a thing in my life. I never stole a thing.
Hey, what are you doing with my wallet?
Well, I'm just there in case somebody sneaks in and tries to steal it. Then they've got me to reckon with. There's your wallet.
Oh,
thank you.
Here, vote for me. There's plenty more where that come from.
Now, if you didn't hold up the stagecoach, then you won't mind if we search this place.
Well, I'll help you. Here, close that thing there, will you? There's a draft coming in here from that cold cash. Nothing under there. Nothing back there. Yuck! Well, 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
A great deal of money was swiped by this bank. If you want to find it, just ask for a drink.
Drink?
Of water, madam.
Boy, I tell you, rhymes like that could make Lawrence Welk bust his bubbles.
All right, Deadeye. How about a drink of water?
Oh, you don't want to drink that stuff. It's hard water. It's hard water. Real hard water.
What makes it hard?
Well, you see, it comes from down creek, and if you drink it, I'm going to be up creek.
I'm going to be the bartender.
All right, just pump away there. Sounds like a storm coming up, don't it, huh? Yeah, see, I told you there ain't no money in there.
Jackpot.
You said there was stolen money there.
I tried to expose you, but you were too smart.
I'm glad they don't notice the change in my heart.
Well, thanks for dropping in and suspecting me, folks.
Sheriff.
Yeah?
Confidentially, you clink.
I wouldn't touch that straight line with a 10-foot pole. Well, you ain't no rose yourself. Is that what you're digging at?
Well, there's no evidence of stolen loot. Guess we'll have to wait till next election to prove he's crooked.
Yeah. Right.
Now, Mr. Appleworm, what can you sing to that?
How do you like that? I'm losing an election and he's making an album.
The sheriff is guilty. Your proof is right here. Why don't you try yanking George Washington's hair?
No, don't pull old George's hair. Don't do that. It's a pigtail and he'll own it. Don't do that. So. Well, sir, now you know the worst about me. I keep an untidy chimney.
Did I? I demand to know how money from the First National got here.
Well, I'll tell you, there was a bank robber. There was a bank robber, and he was stealing the money. And I had to chase him halfway up my chimney before he got away.
Oh, did I? That's a bald-faced lie.
What do you expect? I got a bald face.
Are you going to give it back?
I'm sorry I kept the money.
Are you going to give it back?
I said sorry, not stupid.
Well, the election's tomorrow, and no honest citizen in town is going to vote for you. Come on, folks.
Darn sure.
Son, are you a folk singer? Yeah. You a folk singer?
Yes, sir.
Why don't you go home and sing to your folks?
I'll clean up the city and make you resign.
Will you clean
up your way, and I'll clean up mine.
The same as George Murphy, I'll soon get my chance, but I'll do the singing because I can't dance.
Now remember, folks, I only need 4 more votes to win this election. Now I'm appealing to you upstanding citizens to give me your vote. It's simple arithmetic, boys. If all of you vote for me, that gives me 4.5 votes. Or one of you can just vote 4 times and that'll get me in, but not by a landslide. Well, gentlemen, how about a vote of confidence?
That's all right, get out of here.
Well, I see you're still a little undecided.
What a jail, Deadeye. You got me in here for drinking, and I ain't had a drop yet.
I run a tight jail. And boy, you got a breath to prove it.
Says who?
I tell you, if you ever go, don't let them cremate you, boy. With all that alcohol in you, you'd burn for 10 months.
What a crummy jail. Just look at the lumps in my mattress.
Well, that's camel hair on there. Maybe that's one of the humps in it. Yeah, that's a knife. Maybe when it starts lumping up like that, the sheets ought to be changed. We change them once a year, you know, from one bed to the other.
And we ain't none of us gonna vote for you unless you have 2 things here.
Well, yeah, that's not
all that, fellas.
None of us.
Oh, you stay out of this.
Watch him, hold him. I don't trust him.
I'm wise to all you 8-foot Texans with all the hot air kicked out of you. You don't like the jail, huh?
No.
Well,
sir.
That's what I'm going to do right now is make some improvements. Whoa, I'll make so many improvements around here that we'll have to put on a cover chair to keep out the riffraff.
Well, let's see.
I'd like to introduce my new jailkeeper.
Woo-hoo! Girl!
What did you pick?
How about that?
Well, that's a funny way to hook a man.
There you go. Right ahead, ma'am. Go right ahead.
Right on in there. Now, if any of you want to apply for life sentences, I'm taking applications now.
Gosh, Deadeye, this is great.
Yes.
It sure is. Thank you, sir.
Sir? Well, I guess when you go through life staring at people's knees, you can't tell the difference.
Do we still have to do our exercise on the rock
pile? No, your exercise is going to be champagne breaks from now on. Each man gets a bucket of champagne.
Where's the exercise?
Falling down and picking yourself up.
Well, this sure is living, Sheriff. But what about our wives?
Let them get their own booze, huh? Pass out the ballot, Colonel. Pass out the ballot, please.
Oh,
now, everybody hurry up and make your marks. Make your marks.
Right ahead. I can't vote for you.
Why?
I don't know how to make an X.
Well, make a Y and pull the tail down.
Oh, man.
Well, that's why you're in jail and I got my own show. Good heavens, old tone deaf's back again. I tell you, I wish that was electric guitar. I'd plug it in and ask you to sit down. Johnny Appleworm, I'm arresting you.
Arresting him? What's the charge?
No charge. It's free.
The polls are about to close, Deadeye.
The sheriff has fooled you with more of his frauds. Everything's rented, including the...
Well, you lose.
What are you going to do now, Deadeye?
I'll tell you, folks. Give me a hum, will you?
Hum.
What's your next song?
When we have the recount, your sheriff I will be. We'll tally the ballots.
Get little old me.
And sing it again.
Sing it again, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's our guest star for tonight, Mr. Johnny Mathis. Johnny, everyone knows what a fine singer you are, but I'll bet very few people know that you're also a great athlete.
Well, thank you, Ed.
Yes. When he was on the team of San Francisco State College, he jumped 6 feet, 5 1/2 inches, right?
Right, but nowadays there are a lot of fellows who can even jump 7 feet, so.
7 feet? Why, you know that's 3 1/2 Mickey Rooney's.
Right, in fact, the world's record is 7 feet, 5 3/4 inches, and it's held by a Russian.
Probably Khrushchev when they kicked him out.
No, Red, the name of the record holder is Valerie Brumel.
You know, I think it's time that they brought the title back to the United States. We should bring the record back here. Now, I'm the guy to do it. You know, I'm quite an athlete myself. I come from an athletic family. My father, during the Depression, was a rum runner. And forget what I said I used to do during rehearsal.
Well, I noticed the high jump standard there, and
I can jump over 8 feet. I'm here to prove it tonight. That's why I got that out here. I don't want you to just think I ad-libbed this just now.
This is 8 feet.
8 feet. One.
That's 8 feet.
Would you try that again? Boy, if he ever kicked you, you'd walk 3 blocks on your toes. All right, here I come, Johnny. I'm going to jump away.
Wait, you have to get far.
No, I'm right here. This is it. Okay, folks, get ready. Call Ed Sullivan. I'm sitting in the audience. Now bring on the lions! Bring on the lions!
Wait a minute. You didn't jump over 8 feet.
You want to bet on that, buddy? Right here they are.
Excuse me, you're right.
You figure that out. Now, ladies and gentlemen, a very talented singer, Mr. Johnny Mathis.
See who you are.
feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual.
The moment that you speak, I wanna go play hide and seek.
I wanna go and bounce the moon, just like a toy balloon.
You and I are just like a couple of tots running across a meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots.
You know you've got me feeling so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung, bells to be rung, and a wonderful thing to be clung. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do today. 'Cause you make me feel like young.
Like young. Like young.
The Silent Spot, starring Red Skelton in The Spirit of Halloween. Don't go away. Red will be back in a minute. Here he is again, Red Skelton.
On behalf of our sponsors and staff, may we thank you for allowing us to be a part of your evening. And we sincerely hope that our products and our entertainment has brought happiness into your homes. So until next week, we say goodbye for now, and may God bless. Good night.
Heave-ho, mate, gotta go, mate. Clear the decks and return to the shore.
Look across our bow.
7 days from now, we'll be sailing and whaling once more. So goodbye. Until the moment when we'll see you all again. To our friends near and far, fare thee well, au revoir.
The song, On a Clear Day, was pre-recorded. Art Gilmore speaking.